Welcome to Politics and Why with Sky. Schneps Media is asking each candidate running for New York City office this year three questions in 3 minutes to get to know them in a candid way. And right now I'm with Frances Spangenberg, who's running for New York City Council District 19 in Queens. So let's get to know him a little bit. Frances, tell us about yourself and why you're running for office this year.
Well, my name is Frances Spangenberg, and that's how it's going to appear on the ballot. But most people do know me as Frank, so do not be confused. Frank and Frances are the same person. I've lived in this district my whole life. I live in Douglaston now, although I grew up in Flushing. I went to St. Andrew Abellino Elementary School, and then on to Bishop Riley High School, and then Queens College. And I taught high school for a number of years after college, but in 1986, I made a career change, and I became a police officer. And I started in the old transit police. 1995, the city merged all of its police departments together. And so most of my career was with the NYPD. I did all sorts of different things over the course of my career. And my department sent me for 1 year up to the University of Albany to get a master's in criminal justice. And then they sent me off to Harvard to get a master's in public administration. And when I came back, I figured I need to finish my education. So while still working full-time for the NYPD, I completed a doctorate in criminal justice, and I was invited to become an adjunct professor in the graduate program at John Jay. And I finally retired from the NYPD in July of last year. As for running, well, my whole life has been about serving my community. I served it as a teacher. Served it as a police officer, and I want to continue serving it. And with my knowledge and my experience that I've derived from my life, I think I have a great deal of important, valuable experience that I can best use in the community as a member of the city council.
Frank, with your background in law enforcement, maybe can you give us the shortest answer about, with your experience in police, what the solution is to some of this conversation about defunding the police, reimagining the police, safety and security?
I think that it is always a bad idea to build public policy around a slogan rather than around hard facts, around research, around looking at what does and does not work. Defund the police, I think, is an ill-thought-out slogan. You cannot defund the police unless you have some other agency already up and running and ready to step in and take over whatever function it is you want to take from the police. We don't have that. And in order to get there, you actually need to fund two things simultaneously, which is not going to happen in a time of budget constraints. What we really need to do is to concentrate on better training. And I'm talking about training, not just in the academy, but constant ongoing training throughout the career of police officers. A proper kind of training, I think that training should involve a great deal of community input. If you want to have police officers who interact better with the community, then you do that by having police and community members from the same precinct sitting down and talking to each other face-to-face and learning about each other as individuals to understand that they're not just abstractions, but they're people. And I think we need better recruitment.
Did we ever do that, community policing? Isn't that what that is?
No, that's not what that is. Community policing is one of those words like socialism that it can mean absolutely anything to anybody, depending upon who's using it. One idea behind community policing is that it's the community deciding what laws are going to be enforced and what laws aren't. But that's not very good in a diverse place like New York City, where you walk from one neighborhood into another and suddenly something that was okay here is not okay there. That doesn't work. On the other hand, the type of community policing that does work is having a more direct interaction between community members and specific members of the precinct who are working in that neighborhood, so that the cops know the people know the cops. That is the sort of community policing that actually does have an effect in improving relations between people and the police who serve them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Frank, do you want to share anything fun or interesting about yourself that you wouldn't normally say on a political interview?
Oh, sure. I'll tell you the one thing that why many people in my district know me, or at least know of me, that has absolutely nothing to do with politics. And that's a weird claim to fame, that for 13 years, I had the record for the most money won on Jeopardy in regular play. Back in 1990, back when you could only stay five shows and the dollar values were half what they are, I was the very first person on Jeopardy who ever went over $100,000 in 5 days of play. And that record stood for 13 years.
Wow! And
I've been back a number of times for tournaments and for things like that, but a lot of people recognized me just from those first 5 days, all those years ago. Back in March, when I was out with my petitions, getting signatures, you know, you have your face mask on and, you know, people can't see your face. But while people are looking at my petition, they see the name and they say, Spangenberg. Wait, are you the guy who won all that money in Jeopardy all those years ago? And it's kind of nice being recognized that way.
Oh, that's such a great story. Thanks for sharing that with us, Frank. Your claim to fame, a famous member here running for city council. Thank you for being part of Schnepps Media. 3 questions in 3 minutes. Good luck to you on Politics NY with Sky.
You take care.